Hello and welcome to our next InnovaPhone My Apps tutorial. In this video, we will show you the basic functions of My Apps and how you can customize My Apps. So go ahead and open My Apps on your device. For our video, we will be using a Windows 10 computer. First, you will see your empty home screen and maybe phones that have already been registered. If you click on All Apps on the bottom right, you will be able to view all apps that the administrator has made available for you. You can now add an app to your home screen by clicking onto the house symbol next to the app you would like to add. The home button is always displayed at the bottom left, and once you click onto it, you will get back to your home screen. The selected apps are now on the home screen. We will get back to this just in a second. You can get to your own account settings by clicking onto the hamburger button at the top right corner. When you click on Edit Profile, you can select your profile picture and your username. You can also change your password here. Here you can also adjust your own privacy settings. Who is able to view which activities? Individualized in your domain or self-configured groups and filters. You can also set up a permanent call diversion if you are busy or if there is no response. You can join or leave groups. Further, you can manage your phones. Simply add new phones or delete them if no longer needed. The X at the top left corner will close the app that is currently open. If you choose Account Security in the hamburger menu, you can log out of the current session. Here you can also check other logins and remove these if you wish to do so. The client My Apps will be closed once you click on Exit. With standard apps, you can select the standard apps to make phone calls and to chat. In order to switch to another language, click on the currently set language and select the language you would like to have displayed. You have two options with the overall design. You can either opt for dark or light. The elements on your home screen can either be displayed as icons only or with medium or large details. If you click on More, you can activate and deactivate the auto start of My Apps. You can also determine when you would like to appear offline. You can select hotkeys and you can choose the docking settings of My Apps. The client will then either open up in a normal window or will be docked to the left or the right of your screen. Now, let us see how we can customize the home screen. In addition to the apps you have selected, you can also add contacts to your home screen. Using drag and drop, you can rearrange the elements as you please. If you drag an element to the very bottom, a new group will be created and you can enter a group name. This gives you the possibility to create an organized and structured home screen. You can also rearrange entire groups via drag and drop, just as you can arrange single elements. Once you open up new apps, these will be displayed on the bottom next to your home button. By clicking onto the icon, you can bring the app back to the front. If you click on the X at the top left corner, the app will close. Press the little arrow symbol right next to it and the window will be docked off. If you press the arrow symbol again, the window will be docked onto the client again. You can view your present status at the top left corner of My Apps. You can either have it synced with your calendar or you can make entries manually and add a notification. Many thanks for watching and enjoy testing for yourself. In the next tutorial, we will be taking a closer look at the phone app.